Hello friends, myself Halawat Ramesh. Basically, I am from chemistry background. Today, we will talk about some most common chemistry interview questions and answers. After completion of BSc Chemistry, MSc Chemistry, MPhil Chemistry, PhD Chemistry, and B pharmacy students, M pharmacy students, if you go to various companies or if you go to any job interviews regarding that chemistry as a chemist or the pharma industries, most of the they will ask you some few questions and I prepared a few question and answers. Most of these questions are repeated questions if you go anywhere for in chemistry background questions. Okay, today we will talk about one by one slide about the some chemistry questions and answers. Okay, we will see by most common chemistry questions and answers. Learn chemistry, think chemistry, and practice chemistry. You can see the first one question here. What is the body temperature? First question. What is the body temperature? They will ask you while you are going to interview. They will ask very general questions, right? What is the body temperature? The answer is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 Fahrenheit. Next question, second one question is define pH. What is the pH of the blood? What is pH? The negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration is called pH. The blood pH is 7, that is, you know that everyone, 7.35 to 7.45. Next you can see here, next third one question, explain the term of elutes and dilutant. What is elute? A measured sub volume of original sample, that is called elutes. What is dilute? Material with which the sample is diluted, that is called dilutant. Okay, and next you can see that fourth one question here, explain what is titration. Titration means, it is very simple, titration is also known as volumetric analysis. Titration means that is a nothing but a volumetric analysis. This is a quantitative chemical analysis to determine the concentration of an identified analytes. A reagent termed the titrant or titrator is prepared as a standard solution of known concentration and value. The titrant reacts with a solution of analyte to determine the analyte's concentration of value of titrant that reacted with the analytes is termed as titration value. This is the meaning of what is titration. Okay. Sorry. Next fifth one question is, what are the types of titration? Mostly you know everyone, four types of titrations there. There are the four types of titration. First one, acid based titration. Second one, complexometric titration. Third one is precipitation titration. Fourth one, redox titration. You can see what is the basic acid based titration, in which an acid or base titrant react with an analyte that is a base or a acid, that is called acid-base titration. Next, complexometric titration means involving the metal ligand complexation reaction. Next, third one is the precipitation titration, in which the analyte or titrant react to form a precipitate, that is called precipitate titration. Fourth one is redox titration, where the titrant is an oxidized or reducing agent, that is called redox titration. Next you can see the sixth one question, what is room temperature? What is the, it is very general question. 25 degrees centigrade, it is the room temperature. Seventh one question, what is the ultraviolet and visible spectroscopy range? The UV spectroscopy range 200 to 400 nanometer and visible spectroscopy range is 400 to 800 nanometer. That is a very common in spectroscopy question they will ask you. Any questions? Next one, eighth one question, what is osmosis? What is osmosis means, a process by which the molecules of a solvent tend to pass through a semi-permeable semi-permeable from a less concentration solution into a more concentrated one. That is called osmosis. Ninth one, what is the use of UV spectroscopy? What is the use of UV spectroscopy? It is a general question. Spectroscopy used for detecting the functional group impurities. Qualitative and quantitative analysis can be done by UV spectroscopy. Tenth one question, what is the difference between qualitative and quantitative analysis? Suppose we will see, qualitative analysis means involves the identification of the compound or chemical based on their chemical or suppose absorption or emission or physical properties, melting point and boiling point comes under the qualitative. What is quantitative means it involves the estimation or determination of concentration or amount of a chemical compounds or components. That is called quantitative analysis. Next, 11th question you can see here. Expand LC-MS and HPLC and UPLC and TLC and GC. So LC-MS means liquid chromatography. HPLC means high performance liquid chromatography. Ultra high performance liquid chromatography. TLC means thin layer chromatography. GC means gas chromatography. These are the some expand that abbreviations of these HPLC in this. Next you can see the 12th question. If you talk about 12th question, explain the principle of ultraviolet spectroscopy. Explain the principle of ultraviolet spectroscopy. What is UV spectroscopy? If you see that UV spectroscopy use light in the UV part of electromagnetic spectrum. UV absorption spectra arises in which molecules or atoms under outer electrons absorb energy, undergoes transition from lower energy to higher energy levels. For each molecule absorbed, that wavelength is specific. Okay, and then if you see this principle of ultraviolet spectroscopy, UV spectroscopy uses light UV as a part of electromagnetic spectrum. UV absorption spectra arise in which the molecules or atoms and outer electron absorb energy, undergoes transition from lower energy level to higher energy level. For each molecule's absorbed, wavelength is specific. 13th one, explain about Beer-Lambert's law. It states that the intensity of monochromatic light absorbed by a substance dissolved in a fully transmitted solvent is directly proportional to the substance concentration and the path length of the light through the solution. That is the main concept of the Beer-Lambert's law. Next one, explain the infrared spectroscopy principle. What is the main concept of the IR spectroscopy? Suppose if you see that when a molecule is absorbed the infrared radiation, it vibrate and gives rise to pocket like infrared absorption spectrum. This IR spectra is specific for every different molecules absorbed to identify the functional groups. The main concept of IR spectroscopy to identify the functional groups. That point is important. Next one, explain the difference between QC and QA. Provides the confidence that a product will fulfill the quality requirements. QC determines and measure the product quality levels. That is the difference between QA and QC. Okay, and next one, see 16th one, explain the IQ, OQ and PQ and DQ. IQ means installation qualification, operational qualification, performance and design qualification. Next one, what is the principle of HPLC principle? High performance liquid chromatography. This is a technique used for to separating the mixture of components into individual components based on absorption, partition and ion exchange and size exchange principle. Stationary phase and mobile phase used in it. HPLC used for identification, quantification and purification of components from the mixture. That is the main concept of HPLC principle. Next one, explain the HPLC instrumentation. It involves the solvent. These are the very important questions. It involves the solvent system, pump, sample injector, HPLC column, detector and recorder. Firstly, solvent means mobile phase is degassed from the estimation of bubbles. It pass through the pump in uniform pressure. The liquid sample is injected into the mobile phase flow stream. Then it passes through the stationary phase identified by the detector or recorder. Okay. 19th one question, in reverse phase HPLC, which type of stationary phase is used to give example? Non-polar stationary phase is used and silica gel C18 is used. Next 20 question, if you see that 20th question, what are the detector used in HPLC? In HPLC, what are the detectors they are using? One, UV detector, IR detector, fluorescence detector, MOS spectroscopy, LC-MS. These are the some common used the HPLC detectors. How to calculate the retention factor in paper chromatography? The RF is calculated by RF is equal to distance traveled by solute by distance traveled by solvent. Next 12th one, next 22 question is, define molarity, number of moles of solute in per liter. The donated by capital N. Next, molality, number of moles of solute for kilogram solvent, that is called donated by small m. Next one, define drug, the substance intended for use in the diagnosis, cure, mitigation, reduction of pains, treatment or prevention of diseases. This is the definition of drug. Next one, 25th, expand the NOEL or MSEO, CAPA, QMS, OOS, OOE. No observed effect levels, maximum available carryover and corrective action and preventive actions. These are the some abbreviation. Next one, see the why phosphate buffer generally used in RP chromatography. Because it has three protonated form, H3PO4, H2PO4 and HPO4 twice, which has 3 pKa values 2.7 and 12 respectively. Next one, you can see the 27th, what is the stability indicate SI method? It is the qualitative analytical methods, it can detect any change with time. Next, what is mass balance? Any increasing in degree dead value is indicated by corresponding drop in SI value, that is called mass balance. From that total 28 questions, from that I will close my lecture. If you like this video, please like, share and comment. Next one, see the 29th. What is that difference between SI and potency? Potency means it is the purity of compounds which state the percentage available of main compound without water and residual solvent. SI means it is define a potency and water as residual solvent. SI and potency are the same when SI expressed in the basis. 31 last bit. What is the elution order for acidic and basic components in chromatography? Acids have maximum retention at lower pH. Base have the retention time at lower pH. They are fully charging. This order was say rise be higher pH. Okay. If you like this video, please like, share and comment. Next video, I will detail explain about the few questions. Thank you, boy. See you. If you like, share and comment. And the next video I will upload clear about the BSc, MSc and PhD chemistry common analytical questions and answers. So these are the mostly repeated questions they are asking in any companies. If you are going to interview like Reddy's, Aurobindo, Hetero Pharma, Drugs companies, these are the repeated questions for as a chemist. These questions are I given mostly 30 questions. These are very